Hello, welcome to this mode, episode 226, week 64. This is ECW, and the Bucket Man has arrived.
Damas y caballeros, les presento a un hombre con un corazón de león, una leyenda, la ascensa excelencia, el orgullo de la gente, Alberto
Right, so kicking off tonight, we have a triple threat match between three of the newly drafted men to ECW. Alberto Del Rio was in the public draft, and the two other men are yet to be known of, according to the ECW general manager, keeping them on a secretive basis, and we'll find out who they are tonight. Del Rio was, of course, drafted over at the courtesy of Sheamus, who is going to be on this show in the main event later on tonight, but I'm going to be looking forward to seeing who's going to be kicking off this episode of ECW, who else has been drafted over. Because, like I said, with Del Rio, you know, ECW could be a place for Del Rio to hone his craft, to become a new man again. Because it's been quite a fall for Del Rio for some time, but depending on who these two men are, I guess it really depends on who is going to be winning this match, I suppose. Oh my goodness!
And approaching the ring,
I keep on forgetting to take that shirt. Keep on forgetting. Why does he wear that shirt? I don't know. But Bo Dallas has been drafted to ECW. How about that? There we go. That's a signing there for ECW. All right, Bo Dallas. There we go. ECW will now get the chance to Bo leave. I'm pretty sure we did just see this. But, you know, Bo Dallas pointing to his Bo leavers. In fact, everyone here is a Bo leaver. That is just a fact. But, anyways, Bo Dallas does Del Rio like things with Del Rio in the ring. We are going to be seeing who else has been signed to ECW. Okay, this is a pretty big pick. The undefeated EC3. That is a draft pick for ECW right there. That is a very good pick in the supplemental draft. Like I said, EC3 undefeated and arrives on ECW. This is a pretty damn good pick. And EC3 to think as well, won a draft pick for SmackDown. Who did he win? I cannot remember. I don't think it was anyone big. Though it was probably someone who was not that big of a name. Let me think. No, I can't remember. Alright, but anyway, EC3 heading into the ring now. This is going to be an interesting triple threat to start off ECW, and of course the rest of the match card will follow once I've talked through it. I'd also like to apologize at any point if a loud buzzing noise is in the background later in this video. It is very, very warm. Over here now, and oh, I have the reversal indicator on. I'm gonna have to get rid of that. But yeah, it's very warm in Wales. It's a shocker, and because of that, because I have a computer in this room as well, and because I have a very small room, it gets very hot in here very fast, and I may need to turn on the fan. The fan makes the infamous return from old pay-per-views of the past. But anyway, let's not talk about that. Let's talk about the match card right now after this. The Briscoes take on another new signing from the supplemental draft, a tag team player. It's the Briscoes versus the Kingdom. Then we have two new as well, both from Monday Night Raw. I thought EC3 there with a hook and ladder. As Razor Ramon takes on the man who's returned from that injury multitude of injuries he sustained, that man being The Miz. Then Sonata takes on the ECW television champion Jimmy Jacobs, and for the main event, Sheamus takes on Eddie Guerrero as Bo Dallas. Oh, these Bo leaving punches. Bo leave that! Wow, that was something. Bow into the pin. Oh, Del Rio, though, gets the shoulder up. Bow looking like he was about to get that one in the bag there. EC3, of course, staying back as he should. He is undefeated and he wants to keep that streak going. Bow could be out right now. Oh, he Bow leaved enough and he stayed in it. Oh, he catches the boot. The Bow sleeper hold. Okay, Del Rio taps. Why is that his finisher? I don't know. Oh, the 1%er though to Bow Dallas. Oh, poor Bow. EC3 into the pin. Believe that. Undefeated streak continues. EC3 wins this match. I don't think there's any stopping EC3 for a long time. And this has been a good introduction to the land of ECW. EC3, ECW. It's a damn conspiracy. The 3 is a W that's done a 90 degree. Alright, but anyway, let's head into our next match as the Briscoes take on the Kingdom. Interesting. The Briscoes, anyway, as this Ring of Honor match takes over ECW. Of course, the Briscoes, former ECW tag team champions, defeated Europe's Finest in their first reign, their dominant first reign, to become ECW tag team champions. Since then, you know, it's not been the best, but it's still been good when you think about it. And tonight they take on the Kingdom. Adam Cole and Michael Bennett, too, of course. Well, they're not exactly the best of teams getting along. Well, when I say that, I mean that, you know, Cole is sort of not liking Bennett that much, but at the same time, they do get the job done. And I talked about this previously about how it could just be jealousy on Adam Cole's side because Bennett's got a WWE Championship shot in a short amount of time here, but who knows between these teams anyway. On ECW, maybe they can have a fresh start. Maybe they can put all that behind them, and maybe they can focus on taking those ECW Tag Team Championships away from Power and Glory. But, you know, it's a debut team, and it could take some time. But with the reputation the Kingdom have, of course, on Raw, they were a pretty good team. They never captured the World Tag Team Championships, but they haven't been around that long. But, who knows? Anyway, with Adam Cole and Michael Bennett, let's see if they can get off to a cohesive working start against this team. Even the ECW crowd seem to like Michael Bennett.
And his tag team partner from Boston, Massachusetts, Michael Barnett.
I mean, Adam Cole didn't come out to the best of reactions, but Michael Bennett came out to a very nice reaction there from the crowd. That was good welcoming. So I was telling, like I was saying, Michael Bennett, you know, he seems to be more liked by the fans. He seems to be more respected by them. Maybe that's why Adam Cole's jealous, but who knows. Anyway, let's see what the Kingdom can get up to against the former ECW Tag Team Champions here on ECW. Of course, with Europe's Finest, unfortunately, no longer a thing. It's sort of anyone's ball game, really, to take those ECW Tag Team Championships. I mean, you still have the dominant team, as we've seen, of Power and Glory, but they weren't really that dominant against a fucking jobber team last week. But, what was I going to say? But you never know, you know, I mean, that was just a first showing. Sometimes nervous happenings happen. It's a happening. But, who knows? I mean, it is, like I just said, it is anyone's ballgame. Maybe the Kingdom could capture tag team gold on this roster. And maybe singles gold, who knows? Nice kick to the face there by Adam Cole, because, of course, the Briscoes have already done what some teams have, of course, already done before. They have captured these WWE Tag Team Championships, and I imagine they would like to also hold it again. Who's going to get the advantage and maintain control? I think it's Jay Briscoe in the ring right now. Yep, that is definitely Jay. I like the for some reason, they are both extremely bold. Oh, hanging on there. I know Adam Cole, being a little bit cocky there, was able to pull down Jay Briscoe, and now look, he's just shown off. Crowd not really liking that. Mark Briscoe tagged back in. And now in comes Michael Bennett. Here we go. Bennett trying to unload. Dodges the punch. Nice bulldog there.
And now it is show-off time. Don't waste time floating here.
Bennett with a duck under. Mark Briscoe. Oh, few strikes reversed. Wrench in the arm. Nice reversal there. Another quick arm drag, duck under, and Bennett now exploding with a Luthez press.
Good Lord, what a series of strikes.
As he picks up Mark Briscoe now, side headlock, knee to the skull, high knee there, shoulder tackle. Bennett to the top, rope elbow drop, nicely connected there. Bennett seems to be rather comfortably in control now as he slowly takes control of the arm. Wrenching it back there. Bennett looking good right now. Went for a kick to the gut. Mark Briscoe lands one of his own. Jay Briscoe tagged in. Adam Cole back tagged back in. Here we go. Oh, lovely enziguri by Adam Cole. He's got himself stuck in a corner, though. He's got himself stuck in the Briscoe's corner. And this will use to take advantage. Cole, though, quickly trying to fight out. There's a tilt-a-whirl neck breaker. As again, he shows off. Much to the crowd's dismay. A few strikes. Behind. Quick chin lock down. Oh boy, Adam Cole. Huge knee drop there. And a flip leg. Cole gonna try and take it to the top rope. Oh, he's been reversed. Oh no. Oh my. Oh, okay, I thought he was going for a hurricanrana. Jay Briscoe. Double underhook suplex off the top rope. And he's not done there. Strikes to the face now.
Oh, the punch connects.
As he picks up Adam Cole. But Cole with a quick reversal. In the corner goes Briscoe. But Briscoe with a reversal. In the corner goes Cole. And oh, there's another reversal. Adam Cole is really enjoying showing off right now. That might not be the best of ideas. Tag made anyway. In comes Bennett. Mark Briscoe back in. Oh no! Uranagi! AKA go back to Japan. I think. No, go back to Japan's submission hold. I'm sorry, I got it all wrong. Anyway, he's setting up for the move that I now know the name of. It is the photo finish! Oh my god, he just busted open Mark Briscoe. Jay Briscoe is up on the ropes. Oh! Michael Bennett trying to take care of something Adam Cole couldn't do.
I can't believe everything that's transpired this.
Maybe Adam Cole did that on purpose because he wants to be the winner. Bennett tagging in Cole. And with a busted open Mark Briscoe, this is the opening that the Kingdom could have had there. This is what they could have used to win. Jay wants back in this match. Adam Cole making sure that's not going to happen. Irish whip into the turnbuckle. But Mark with a reversal of his own. And a huge big boot there in the corner. He's going to go make the tag into Jay now. There we go, Jay Briscoe in. He may have to go about this one. Without the assistance of Mark Briscoe, who knows what kind of condition Mark's in. Again, he's looking for that sideways kick to the head. Oh, look at that one for the elbow. And Adam Cole moved out of the way. Michael Bennett helping the huge chop across the chest. Adam Cole really is showing off a bit too much. And yeah, he paid the price for that there with a nice uppercut from Jay Briscoe. Irish whip though back in the corner. Tag made, and Bennett now. Kick to the gut. Two strikes. Oh my god, back and forth reversal by the two men there. These two teams having quite a back and forth match. Oh god, Adam Cole is certainly getting in the way of something there. And he's shaking the ropes a bit. Back suplex. Frequent tags being made by the Kingdom is leading to a successful method of victory. Jay Briscoe though with the reversal and an elbow to the back. And he's going to go tag in Mark. This could be a mistake. Oh my god. Mark Briscoe though catches him somehow for a spine buster. Oh, but a poke to the eye, or a poke to the even busted open skull, maybe, of Mark Briscoe as a reverse DDT connects there. Reversal, though, by Mark Briscoe. Oh, Adam Cole looking to try and put this one away. Roll up. Roll up. He got him. No. Briscoe with a kick out. Drop kick across the face there. Oh, my God. What is... What is... Oh, okay. Oh, God. That was Scorpion Death Drop. Totes. And that did not look nice. Oh, Jay Briscoe, though, tagged in. Here we go. No, Adam Cole ducks under that. Kick to the gut. But he's reversed. Oh, look at these clubbing strikes to the face of Adam Cole, who's now locked off in the Briscoe's corner. Where they want him. Camel clutch locked in. Totally not. The accolade. Michael Bennett seems to be having troubles breaking it up. Adam Cole gets to the ropes. Oh my God, he's still getting stomped. Chop kick there, not fully connecting. Adam Cole! Fuck Florida Key, I think. That may be it. Into the pin. The game has crashed. Oh, just about. Unlucky there by Mark Briscoe. But the Kingdom pick up the win in this contest. Good start on ECW.
Here are your winners, Adam Cole and Michael Barnett.
There we go, the Kingdom get the win. And have some of that Briscoe's, unfortunate for them, but that was a pretty good contest between both teams. Back and forth. But Bennett and Cole are the winners here tonight. There we have it. So the Kingdom getting off to a good start in ECW. Let's see if Razor Ramon or The Miz can get off to a good start as they take each other on one-on-one next.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Miami, Florida, weighing 289 pounds, Razor Ramon.
So Razor Ramon, I can't remember the last time we saw him, but he recently was not doing that well on Monday Night Raw, to be fair to him. And he left at kind of a bad time when the United States Championship's vacant, and we don't know what's going to happen to that title, but like I said, he sort of left at a bad time, but who knows? Maybe Razor, like we just saw with the Kingdom. And we saw EC3 can get off to a good start on ECW. But The Miz is going to be wanting to do just the same. And it is his return match. He was, of course, injured, suffered multiple concussions, and he's back and he's blue. Of course, The Miz took a package pile driver onto concrete at No Mercy, and then the next night attempted to take on Kevin Steen, where he was just decimated and was told to take time off. He has done just that, and he is back in action here on ECW. Well, not back in action on ECW, but he's back in action at ECW. This is going to be an interesting start for The Miz. And of course, Razor Ramon. But I see this more so being a Miz victory and a good start for Miz on ECW. Miz has changed it all around, of course, like I said in the last few months, after he disbanded Awesome Truth, after he got rid of R-Truth and moved on from that. He very quickly rose up the ranks. He had a shot at the United States Championship. Then the next show, he had a shot at the WWE Championship. As you can see, I have forgot to set myself to busy. But and then, of course, was injured, but in the short amount of time, the Miz disbanded Awesome Truth, he really did get himself up the rankings, and he's going to be looking to do the same here on ECW. He might be looking to capture the ECW Television Championship from Jimmy Jacobs, but I'm not entirely sure about that. But meanwhile, The Miz and Razor Ramon having a really back and forth match right now. But The Miz taking a bit of control. What is he looking for? Powerbomb, maybe? Oh, shoulder breaker. Nicely done by The Miz. Feels confident with himself after that one, and who can blame him? That was a pretty good maneuver. Razor Ramon, however, looking to regain control. Seems as if these two men are slowly learning how to fight ECW style. I mean, ECW is more of a rougher brand. Back and forth reversals, you know, back and forth by both, by all the men involved in the matches. And Miz with a nice backdrop there. Of course, with the weight difference definitely being in Razor Ramon's favor, it's good that The Miz has been able to lift him on multiple occasions. Miz now with Razor Ramon groggy in front of him. A simple DDT on the skull. Going to be looking for the skull-crushing finale to finish this one away. He is definitely in control, but Razor Ramon instantly stopping his offense there with that arm DDT shtick. Hit to the gut. Front face lock. The Miz, though, reverses that. Oh, and The Miz, whatever he was looking for there, has been reversed. Huge clothesline by Razor Ramon. Walks into a kick to the gut. Single-armed. Yes. Oh, no, The Miz, he's looking for it. He's setting it up here. Turns around Razor Ramon. Skull-crushing finale. It is done. One, two. The Miz picks up the win here. Much to the dismay of Razor Ramon, but like I said, The Miz is going to have to get up to a good start here on ECW. I like this attire. Just getting it out there. Really good. But The Miz is your winner here tonight. Razor Ramon, unfortunate for him. But that just happens. There must be a loser. And there we go. The Miz is beginning on ECW is a good one. Anyway, let's see what happens in the next match when Sanada takes on the ECW Television Champion Jimmy Jacobs in a non-title match. I'm looking forward to seeing what both men can bring to the table. I predict this being a very good match. Well, let's see what happens. Sanada was the runner-up in that Fatal 4-Way Battle Royale. I don't know what it was, like a Fatal 4-Way tournament to determine the number of contender for the ECW Championship. He was the runner-up. Jimmy Jacobs was eliminated first in that Battle Royale, and he's the ECW Television Champion. That makes Sanada slightly annoyed that being the runner-up got him nowhere, really, and he wants to try and prove that Jimmy Jacobs being eliminated first, was not just pure luck. It's because Sanada was the better wrestler, and you know, Sanada was able to last longer than him. For that reason, he should be the ECW Television Champion, not Jimmy Jacobs. So you know, there's a bit of animosity between these two men. Jimmy Jacobs, of course, loving being TV Champion. Sanada believes he should be TV Champion again. I mean, like I said, this is going to be a very interesting match. Pretty sure I didn't change his entrance. No, I didn't. Bollocks. Approaching the ring from Grand Rapids, Michigan, the ECW World Television Champion, Jimmy. I was sure I changed his entrance, but apparently I didn't. We're going to skip through this very quickly. So, yes, Jimmy Jacobs defeated Curtis Axel last week, and he enjoys boxing thin air. That gimmick's going to come to an end this week. Alright. But anyway, yes, we're going to be heading into the match now. Alright, here we go. Both men getting ready to lock up, and Sanada just exploding out of the blocks. He, like I said, he is, well, he's pretty much angry at Jimmy Jacobs for what happened, and he wants revenge. And he's gone off to a very rough, vicious start against Jacobs. Oh my god, just kicks all around, and knees, and strikes, and just, Jesus, he is being vicious. I guess this is what training from Shawn Michaels does to you, maybe. Sanada went for a drop kick again, but Jimmy Jacobs reverses that. Sanada with a side headlock now. Reversal though, drop toe hold. Trying to get back up to his feet now. Jacobs trying to get some control in this match. I mean, he is being able to reverse Sanada's attacks, but Sanada's reversals are looking very vicious. Another tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. And now, standing moonsault. Nicely done. Oh no, is it Tiger Bomb into the pin here? Trying to get a quick win? No, Jacobs pushing him away at one. For a sit-out spinebuster though by Jacobs. Nice reply, but oh. Stopped instantly. Sanada, top rope. Looking for the elbow drop. Shawn Michaels may have tweaked that. As you know, Shawn Michaels very good at doing elbow drops. Sanada with a Sanada cutter. That's the gimmick. Tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Sanada really has been decimating Jacobs in this match. Oh my god, no, 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 no. Pile driver. See that move at least once a show and still doesn't feel okay. Another Tiger Bomb. Jeez, Sonata's just been in control of this match. He is not happy. He really is not happy. Oh my god, he's trying to roll up Jimmy Jacobs now. Jacobs, though, kicks out at two. And oh, Sanada just went for a kick, but Jacobs was lucky to duck that. I don't know. He's really trying to hurt the back, it seems. Sanada has just been in control throughout all of this match. Looking for the Tiger Suplex. Oh, there it is. He's not done there, though. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, my God, I think I already know what's going to happen. Fight out of this, Jimmy. Oh, no. Oh, no, he's got the strike to the back. Jacobs is in trouble. Top rope. German suplex. I think Sanada just decimated the TV champion. There's two. Yes, he has. Sanada wants that TV title back, and he just destroyed Jimmy Jacobs as a proving point. And here comes the ECW champion. I was all like, way, well done. You beat him, O'Reilly. Sanada just destroyed Jimmy Jacobs. That was a vicious showing. Jesus. Alright, anyway. With that out of the way, let's head into our main event. That man on the left, who shouldn't be there. Eddie Guerrero takes on a man who has been drafted back. Former ECW champion, Sheamus. I think I've just said that twice. But anyway, it's Eddie Guerrero versus Sheamus. That's next.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Dublin, Ireland, weighing 272 pounds, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus.
For the first time in almost 5 months, Sheamus is back on ECW. He had a run on Raw for sure. In a month, he captured the WWE Championship. He was a winner-up in this year's Royal Rumble. Fair play. Sheamus had quite a good run on Raw, despite how short it was. But now he's back on ECW. Now he's back to his homeland, looking to recapture that ECW Championship, as I was interrupted there, but it's going to be difficult. Eddie Guerrero has been looking pretty strong recently. I was catching up with Eddie today, talking to him, and he has stated that at Backlash in 3 weeks' time, he does not want to have an opponent chosen for him. Instead, he's holding an open challenge to anyone who feels as if they can take that ECW Championship away from him. So he has said that he will have a one-on-one match with anyone at Backlash. So I'm looking forward to seeing what that's going to happen. If the general manager goes ahead with it, then it is confirmed. We will have Eddie Guerrero against a random opponent as the police pass my house. There they go. Alright, but anyway, it's time for your main event. Eddie Guerrero, Sheamus. I'm looking forward to this match. I believe they've competed before, but certainly not when Eddie Guerrero's been ECW champion, let's say that. It's been a while since Sheamus last saw Eddie Guerrero, and Eddie Guerrero's changed a lot since then. So let's see what happens in our main event of ECW here tonight. After what just happened... Oh my god! Alright, well that didn't connect fully, but you know. After what just happened between Sanada and Jacobs, you gotta be thinking if Guerrero is gonna have the same problem bestow upon him. Is the challenger gonna be dominant? But fair play to him, he did just slam Sheamus like that, which is pretty good strength, but yeah, Sheamus just immediately reversing and an elbow there. Ooh, sorry about that. This is going to be a test for Eddie Guerrero, probably one of the biggest tests he's had since winning the ECW championship. He's going to have to use his speed and versatility like he is right now against Sheamus and just stay away from the power that he brings to the table. Just about connecting with that dropkick there. High rake. Back under though by Guerrero, spinning heel kick as he springs up to the top rope, missile dropkick there. Quick maneuvers, trying to put away Sheamus. Not even a one count. That just shows how strong Sheamus is, the power that Sheamus has. Oh my god. Overhead belly to belly, just throwing Eddie Guerrero there. Front face lock. Oh, suplex. Ouch. Good quick reversal there by Eddie, and a quick reversal back by Sheamus though. Wrench in the arm from behind. Chin lock down. Guerrero with a few stomps and a flip leg drop. Drop kick again. Working over the skull. I'm pretty sure Sheamus' neck did have a spasm when he collided into the corner there. Guerrero picking him up. Oh my god. He's going to slam him. Powerbomb. He does look like he's sucking a dick. Oh, drop kick. Oh, I thought he was going to serve for the 619. Oh, LA Gringo. Drop kick again. Jeez, this is quick work Eddie Guerrero is doing here. Well, not quick work, but, you know, quick maneuvers by Eddie Guerrero. Sheamus, though, bringing him down. Huge strike. There's an elbow. But Guerrero pushes him away. Punch has been reversed. Sheamus wrenching the arm, bringing him down and just sort of yanking it. Oh, there's a reversal. Punch across the face and a spinning heel kick there. Kick to the back. Eddie Guerrero. Oh my god! Bad timing there. Sheamus was able to easily move out of the way of that one. Pushes him back. Eddie with some quick strikes, but just dropped down there. After he goes for that Hurricanrana. Oh, now look at this. Back and forth between the two men. Guerrero just about getting the best of Sheamus. And again, this suplex. Connecting. Using the ropes as leverage. Sheamus back up to his feet. But knocked right back down with that enziguri. Strikes there. Oh, no. Sheamus responding back. Double axe handles. Tilt-a-whirl power slam. Sheamus, the opening he needs into the pin. Guerrero, though, out at one. Went for the drop kick. He moves out of the way. Kick to the gut. A few strikes. Reversal. Irish whip into the corner. Oh, no. Oh, double axe handle across the face. I thought when Sheamus was running there, I really thought he was looking for the brogue. Oh, reversal. And another double axe handle. Eddie in a bit of trouble right now. Oh no. Beating the chest. Oh, it's a... He's messed it up. Hey. Sheamus is all like... Oh no! Sheamus! Celtic cross incoming! Oh god! Huge maneuver there. Guerrero in trouble, maybe. Is this it? Yes, it is! Sheamus defeats Eddie Guerrero. And you gotta think that is maybe giving the ECW general manager other ideas about him having a match of his own. It's David Otunga! David Otunga! No! God damn it, Otunga! How could you? No, they're working together! By God! No! He's the third man! I cannot believe it! This is a screw job if I've ever seen one! Fuck, David Otunga! Anyway, this may give the ECW general manager ideas about having that little randomized match, who knows. But a bad showing for the champions tonight, Sheamus and Sonata both beating the champions, the two singles champions, so who knows what that means heading into Backlash. But anyway, that ends ECW, thank you guys for watching, I'll see you on Friday for SmackDown, take care guys, and ta-ra!